collaboration with Sauti Sol Entertainment and Universal Music Group. Sauti Sol in front of you and Colin, who is from Africa Creative Agency. So the agenda of today is for us to share with you Sauti Sol's plans for 2020. They got signed to Universal Music Group. We've not got a chance to talk to them, get their sentiments, and that's why we're here today. So without further ado, I would like to actually start with a guest. You know, according to our culture, tunazanga now again, isn't it? Okay, so put your hands together for Colin Gayle from Africa Creative Agency.
First of all, thank you everyone for having us today. Really appreciate it. As Anyiko said, I've been here for a long time. I've been coming to Kenya now probably like 10 years now, I think, or maybe longer. We got into business with the boys about a year. I'll give you a little bit of background on myself and the company. We generally say ACA, but it's Africa Creative Agency. So it's an agency that represents the creatives on the continent with a goal to take those creatives to the rest of the world. So our job is to take Sauti Sol and break them in South Africa, to take them to Europe, Asia, North America. That's our primary focus. We're here in Nairobi, we're in Joburg, and in Lagos. And we have an office in Los Angeles. It's funny enough, the concept and the idea for ACA was born on someone's kitchen floor in Nairobi on a Sunday afternoon after brunch. I think I met the boys probably 4 or 5 years ago. I've been a fan for a long time. So the opportunity to work with them when that came, it was an incredible honor for me personally to look at what the guys had done in the last 11 years and where we can now take it to the rest of the world. So Universal was a key part of it. It's a unique opportunity to bring a brand new model to the region. And I think as Kenya's number one group, it was the right move and it was the right time to kind of change what has happened in the past and kind of set a new parameter. We have John, who's from Universal, and Eve, who's from Universal here locally. And so it was a great opportunity to take the boys to the rest of the world.
I also want to say thank you for coming in numbers, and I'm seeing, you know, so many familiar faces in the room. Thank you for all the support you've, you know, given Sauti Sol over the past 11 years. Ciao, I didn't think you were going to come. I just have to say thank you because you gave Sauti Sol the first radio interview. I'm just like so stoked that you're here. Asante sana, ciao. And every other person who came. So I want to just jump to Sauti Sol and maybe we'll start with you, Bien, to tell us about your signing to Universal Music Group. You know, Sauti Sol Entertainment, Soul Generations Records is already an entity by itself, and then with Universal Music Group, we are only guessing that it's going to be bigger and better things. So tell us about, you know, how you guys are feeling about this.
For those who don't know, my name is Bien. I am a quarter of Sauti Sol. I'm so happy to be here this morning, and thank you all for coming. It means everything to us that you people can spare your time and come hang out with us. We have been in negotiation with Universal for the last 3 years, and in the end of 2018, because at the time we were going through a shift of management, we also decided to like flip a coin. Through Colin and talking to Sipo from Universal South Africa, who is the head of Universal in Africa, we managed to finally close in on a deal that had been going on for 3 years of back and forth. Signed an artist deal with Universal, but the deal was tailor-made for Sauti Sol because we are not a greenfield act. We've been in the game for 11 years officially, and officially we are like footballers where we never say how long we've been. We recorded an album. The album is called Midnight Train. We are excited about the album. I hope you guys will be just as excited. The relationship is not like any previous relationship that's happened in Kenya between a major record label and a Kenyan artist. And we've seen in the past that a lot of Kenyan artists get swallowed. This deal is one which Sauti Sol came in also with a lot to bring on the table. So it's a deal that's tailor-made to our specifications, and it's going to take Kenyan music to the next level. Not only Sauti Sol, but even our kids and other aspiring Kenyan musicians are definitely going to benefit from the eyeballs that this is going to bring to the continent. Thank you.
Wally Cup, I wanted to ask you about the upcoming album, Midnight Train. You and Savara are the producers of the group. You've been working on this record for quite a long time. And what can you tell us? What are the collaborations we should expect and any other information?
It's an honor to have, it's a pleasure to have everyone here. With the Midnight Train album, which is our fifth studio album that we've recorded, It's been a great, great journey with ACA and with Universal. And recording this under Universal gave us the opportunity to collaborate with so many different kinds of producers and musicians, songwriters. I mean, we've been independent for the past, what, 5-6 years. And this time we decided to just take a step back and include as many people as we can in the music to get the best out of it. And having Universal really helped us do that. So, for example, we had a producer from the States called Andre Harris, who came and did a couple of tracks in the album. Of course, we were involved as the four of us in all the whole process. And with when it comes to collaboration with artists, we have Shoma Josie in the album. We have Burna Boy in the album. India Ree in the album. We have Soweto Gospel Choir in the album. And others. The great thing about this album, Midnight Train, is it brings out the best of Sauti Sol, having matured to where we are right now musically.
From the beginning, Sauti Sol has always been known as a brand that is very creative. I would say deliberate about your brand, your image, you know, from how you dress, how you sound, how your music videos always come out. So if you could just talk about that and also the inspirations behind Susanna, which I never saw any African, not even African, any video shot like that looks like that. I'm just like, it really took me to another place and I couldn't even believe that this video was shot in Africa.
First of all, recording this album was very... It was a mishmash of stress and happiness, you know, just the thoughts of going through each song, of recording each song. But then the beauty of this album as well is that as we were recording it, we just felt ready. You know, like you're recording it and you just feel like, wow, like that you kind of pat yourself on the back and you're just like, that shit sounds good. Now, aesthetically speaking, that was one of the things that as well was a big portion or is a big portion of what this project is. How do we want to proceed from here? What do we want to represent? You know, what does Savara, Polika, Bien, who are they as individuals? And as well, how do we gel together as a group to incorporate all of that? Looked at not just how we started out, the music that inspired us, you know, growing up with our folks, what their style aesthetic was. Then when we used to be at family gatherings, what our folks used to listen to. With Susanna, which is the beginning, we just really felt that 70s, 80s aesthetic that really just was a part of our upbringing is something that we would like to just portray and to bring back to life, but make it look 2020, make it look 21st century, and make it look really, 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 really cool. And well, I hope we manage to achieve that with Susanna, and you will see that running all through the album, that same aesthetic, that same standard of visual quality, the album artwork. We have an amazing creative director who's Kenyan. His name is Osborne Masharia, who's curating our whole album artwork and the lead single of the album, which is called Midnight Train, the name of the album.
Apart from aesthetic, I just want to insist on something. I would really like you guys to learn and to express it to Kenyans to understand the importance of teamwork. The reason why Sauti Sol has been here is here and has been around for too long. Apart from the music, it's brotherhood, it's teamwork, it's to know that I fail and he lifts me up and he fails and I do it. This thing is a whole national and regional thing for us and for music and for all of you. So write about it, please. Inform people about it. Be quick to write about it so that people can be uplifted, okay? Thank you.
Thank you each and every one of you for your support. Also my team, the people at Anyiko Public Relations, Asante Nisana, I know you are somewhere hustling. Thank you. So bring your cameras, we can take the money photo, and then we start doing the interviews. Well, thank you.